Today I will explain how to test transformer using multimeter. I have one transformer here that is shown here. It has one primary 230 volt. It has secondary 180 volt that has one tapping also. And they are isolated with each other. To check that, we measure six type of resistance in this transformer. First is P. P means resistance of primary winding. It will not show short because this wire is very long. Hundreds of turn will be there, so some value will come, but it will not be open. Similarly, S1 and S2. S1, we will measure the resistance of this winding from here to here. That also will not show short, it will show some value. Then S2, we will measure the resistance between this and this. Then P and S, in between primary and secondary, we will measure the resistance. Because there is no connection, it will show open. If there is any failure of insulation, it will not show open. Then this is core. We measure the resistance primary to core. This is primary winding, this is core. In between these two, we will measure resistance. That also will come open. If there is some shorting or insulation breakup, then this will not come open. Then we will know the damage or not. Similarly, secondary and core. This is secondary, this is core. In between this and this, we will measure the resistance. That again should come open. Now I have connected my multimeter across primary. Here, this is showing 65.2 ohm. It is not showing zero, it is showing some value. So I will write 65.2 ohm. Now I have another small transformer. We will check the primary winding resistance of this also. So I will connect like this here. Now this is showing open. Open doesn't mean that this is bad. Open means I have set value 200 ohm. This means value of resistance is more than 200 ohm. I will increase the scale. Now showing 919 ohm. So this value is much, much more than this. Because this transformer is of a small rating. This is 30 VA. This is about 10 VA. Second thing, this is a very good industrial grade transformer. This is normal commercial transformer. So, after connecting your multimeter here, we have to change the scale. Thus it is showing open doesn't mean that it is bad. There is a possibility that resistance of this winding may be higher. Only thing, it should not be open. Now I am measuring resistance across this. This is this terminal is this. So resistance across this is coming 55.8 ohm. I will write 55.8 ohm. Now I will measure the resistance between these two. 160 volt winding. This is 160 volt winding. This is common. So I will change. Now resistance coming 49.4 ohm. You are seeing here resistance is higher 65 ohm. Here resistance is lowest because turns are more here. The more the turn is, the higher the resistance will be. Lesser the turn, resistance will be less. Across this, turns are very less. Suitable for only 20 volt difference. We will measure here also. Let us see how much comes. See, just 7.3 ohm. From here to here, resistance is very low, only 7 ohm, because turns are very less. Now I have connected my multimeter at this point and at this point, between primary and secondary. This is showing open. This open doesn't mean that this is okay. Because I have set value 200 ohm, we have to set at high value. No, I have set at 2000K. Still it is showing open. Means in between this and this, it is perfect open. There is no insulation failure. This is here. Now I will measure the resistance between primary winding and core. Primary is this. Core, this is core. But this core is connected here using a terminal. Industrial transformer will have a connection like this. A core terminal is brought here and then earth terminal is shown here. So I'll measure between this and this core point. See, it is showing open. This scale is at highest value. So I am checking this primary winding and core. This is showing open, means there is no insulation failure in primary winding. Now I will check secondary and core. This is core. This point I will change to secondary. Again showing open. So all three are open. This means there is no insulation failure. Here or here. Now here I have shown between primary and secondary there will be open. This is for isolating transformer. If it is auto transformer like this, then primary and secondary are shorted in auto transformer. There is no isolation. Then it will not be open. It will show some value. Now to measure turn ratio, we have to give AC here. With this way we cannot measure. At primary, we will give AC voltage here. This value will depend upon the rating of the transformer. And the secondary voltage, we connect a multimeter and measure the voltage here. Then this voltage divided by this voltage will be this turn divided by this turn. This is for one tap. For another tap, we have to connect multimeter like this. So this voltage divided by this voltage will be equal to this turn divided by this turn. This method what I have shown is to check the transformer in the lab or house that it is not failed. In production, in companies, they do so many other tests, not this test. Today this much only.